I specifically remember sitting in the crowd and watching Mike Camden win the Golden State Championship. Fast forward about 2 years later, I'm in the exact same ring winning the exact same championship. And on that night, he propelled himself to the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship. Fast forward to January, we're in the same match, going for his title, Heavyweight Championship.
Get up there.
All right!
Thank you so much!
Thank you! Thank you, Judas! Thank you!
All right, let's take care of it!
Hold him up!
What's cracking, y'all? But I got something to get off my chest, you feel me?
Champion taking advantage of the situation!
Not only did I get my shoulder up before the three count, my quote-unquote homeboy wanna grab me by the tights. Come on out here, Mike. You wanna rob me like a thief in the night? I need to say something to you face to face.
What'd you think was gonna happen? Four men, one winner, one champion.
Fast forward a year later, me and him coming full circle. It's been a long 3 years. And this journey ain't over for me, bruh.
The biggest event in SoCal Pro history. And I always knew it would come down to this. But you, Dizz,
being a fan favorite is one thing.
I didn't put in the work.
Being the heavyweight champion is a whole other thing.
I didn't pay my dues.
With this belt,
sleepless nights, painful mornings.
You're carrying the weight of the entire promotion on your shoulders.
And it all was worth it. Every single drop of sweat.
This might not be the first time you fought for this.
Every drop of blood, every tear shed.
But it could be the last.
Comes down to this.
And the fans gonna have to choose.
This is the culmination of 3 years of busting my ass.
Split down the middle.
Putting in the work.
Mike Camden.
Making sacrifices.
Judiz. Fan favorite versus fan favorite.
Ain't no way in hell I'ma let this pass me by. I earned this. I earned this.
Thank you. for one ball. It has a 60-minute time limit, and it is for the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship. Woo! Introducing first the challenger, down from San Francisco, California, 199 pounds,
ladies and gentlemen, you talk big fight feel. This is what you mean, big fight feel. Mike Camden, the champ. June Dizz, the challenger. 364 days and counting for Mike Camden. But June Dizz said he's earned this. He's earned this.
I mean, you can see the importance of this title defense. Look at all the gold here in front of us, laid before us on our table, and two men that are as close as can be. I mean, Mike Camden even inspired Joe Diz to get in there, to go from fame into actually athlete and performer in there.
That's right, but when they were in the ring just a couple, few months ago, in that four-way elimination match, it was Mike Camden who took the shortcut to pin his friend Joe Diz, and that didn't sit well with Joe Diz.
This is gonna be a battle. They're gonna go tooth and nail. Two evenly matched athletes, but I will tell you, gold fever does take over, and sometimes to save that championship, you'll do just a little bit extra.
You know, Joe Diz says he earned this. He earned this, and that's great. That's great that he feels he earned this, but now it's time to prove it.
There has been no bigger time to say put up or shut up here. Joe Diz has been saying he is coming for the title. Mike Camden, he is saying he is coming to defend. Here we are now.
He did have a big shoulder block on Mike Camden.
And Camden a little surprised. I don't know that he's really seen. He's been in the ring with a lot of different people, a lot of great superstars, but I don't think he's seen the intensity of Joe Diz in a while. Not only that, someone that knows Camden so well. I mean, you had talked about it, them even training together, know each other so well in there. Mike Camden, headlock on Joe Diz.
Hooks in the armbar again. This is a role reversal. A year ago, this was Mike Camden in that challenger role.
That's right.
And now here, Joe Diz finds himself a year later in that same position. Mike Camden knows how Joe Diz feels. This is the biggest event in the history of SoCal Pro Wrestling. The spotlight has never, ever been bigger on any two combatants in this company as it is right now on the champion and the challenger.
I mean, 10-year anniversary coming out of this place as the champion is going to do something huge for either one of these athletes. And you got to ask yourself, I noticed that Mike Camden comes in with two championship belts today. Could he be wearing himself a little thin? You know Judas is only concentrated on one thing and one thing only.
Right, Mike Camden is also the Arizona heavyweight champion. And you got that, but I you got to think, guys. This is the biggest crowd in the history of SoCal Pro Wrestling. You know, yes, there's two things here. You don't want to lose the title, but shoot.
Oh!
You don't want to lose in front of the biggest crowd in history of this promotion. You don't want to go home the loser.
Definitely not. History making today, that's for sure. Not only with the capacity crowd, with the tremendous matches we've had today. I mean, just think about how the Ballards are going to feel tonight walking away with those SoCal Pro Tag Team titles. One of these two gentlemen is going to walk away with this SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship.
That's right. The landscape of this promotion could very well change. We have seen new tag champs, like you said. If we see a new heavyweight champion tonight, it flips everything around. Watch out. Camden with the moonsault lands on his feet. That's the athlete right there.
Wow.
And he looks confident.
He does.
He looks ready.
He is the part, he looks the part, the champion.
Mike Camden has that confidence, that chip on his shoulder. He's earned the respect of everybody. The longest reigning champion in the history of this company, well, tied for the longest reign.
And to think he did that coming back from an injury. I mean, that right there. And these fans, I don't think they quite know which way to go with this. I mean, are they fanning for Drew Dees? I know they love Mike Camden.
Oh! Drew Dees, Snapmare. Trying to recover here.
Oh!
The big kick that lands the elbow.
He definitely got that elbow, yeah, nice.
Covers. Only a three count. Quick thinking there, huh, Ben?
That was great. You saw him miss that kick, came back quick. You have to think quick, especially against Mike Camden. Both athletes, extremely fast, both around the same, I would say about the same measure, same strength level, so it looks like it's very even right now.
Goes to that kick again, misses the elbow, Camden with the cover.
Going to the well one too many times, and looks like that's what he did there.
And listen, we've been around the block a few times, we know that Mike Camden wasn't gonna defeat Judas with that pinfall. But by covering him, he's wearing the back,
right?
He's wearing his opponent down. And that's part of the strategy here.
Speaking of wearing him down, that kick right to the chest, knocking the wind out of Judas.
You know, it's not easy to push another man off your chest. Right, you got 200 plus pounds of Mike Camden on top of you. You gotta physically remove him to get that shoulder up.
Smart move, didn't try that a second time, went for the ropes, knew where he was at, positioning all important in there. Look at the who's who that is in the building tonight. I mean, I thought I saw Ruben Zamora out there. I thought I saw Bart from AWS. I mean, the who's who from an athlete, from a promoter, from a fan standpoint here in the building tonight to watch SoCal Pro Wrestling's 10-year anniversary. Camden with Judas on the outside. Referee beginning his count. Oh, look at this.
Oh! Backdrop right on the ring apron by Mike Camden.
And you had said it before, Mike Camden bringing out a few different things we may not have seen him do before. He is a man that loves being a champion, and he is going to do what it takes to keep that title.
He takes pride. Oh, again! He takes pride in being the champ. He wants to be the best. Everybody wants to be the best, but I think something deep within Mike Camden has become deeply attached to that championship title.
Gold fever, it happens.
You hold that title for so long, right? It becomes a part of you, your identity. What happens when you lose it? Who are you then?
Throws him over. Oh! Nice neckbreaker by Drew Dees. And Camden is hurting.
Great move by Drew Dees. But Camden has put the punishment to Drew Dees. Drew Dees just can't recover quick enough.
Big right hand. And another one.
Oh. Drew Dees laying Mike Camden out. Go.
Pump handle, looks like he's setting up for. Oh, no!
Backbreaker. Cover. No. And I'll tell you what, guys, is it just me or is there something a little different about Mike Camden today?
I'll tell you, we're talking about it. It may be a different type of opponent that he's used to fighting because Jude Dizz is giving him everything he's got. They're going back and forth.
Like, when I'm watching Mike Camden there, I'm seeing a great level of concern.
Almost
like there's a little bit of fear.
And especially with such a competitor.
Oh! Camden lands on his feet, though.
Ah! You see that leap from inside all the way to the outside. Caught Mike Camden with a forearm. Both men are laid out here in front of us.
Jude Dizz just hurling his body over the top rope onto the athlete.
Do you see the way Mike Camden hit that guardrail right in the middle of the back? What kind of damage is that going to do to him? He could do some heavy damage. Looks like Camden slow to get up. Definitely slow to get up. Jude Dizz looking like it's taking up an opportunity.
Watch out! Oh! Jude Dizz with a second dive on a Mike Camden. The crowd here in Oceanside, wall-to-wall capacity crowd. They can feel this. Is this a changing of the guard?
They're both leaving it all out there for sure, giving it all they have because they know they may not get another opportunity like this. Nights like tonight, matches like this can be etched in fans' minds for the rest of history.
Oh!
Oh!
Jude Dizz went for that flying cross body. Unfortunately, he was not even close. Camden with the cover. Really bad, bad move there by Jude Dizz.
And I'll tell you, sometimes you try to plan it out and you think you know what your opponent's going to do. In that case, Jude Dizz just basically mistimed it and did not hit at all. And that was really bad for him. And Camden is now taking advantage of that mistake.
Well, how much do you guys think? Oh, watch out.
Oh, that was half of the Bay Bridge there.
Jude Dizz has got to make the cover. Will this be a new champion? No. How much do nerves play into this matchup for both men, guys?
Nerves, both men. You were talking a little bit about fear. I think it's more excitement from both men not knowing what the outcome of this is going to be. You can see Judas still favoring that stomach. I wonder if not being able to hold that stomach together is what stopped him from keeping that pin. Oh!
Camden floats over. Oh!
Hampton's version of Trouble in Paradise. Is that from the guy from the video? No.
No, that's not that. That's Kofi. Okay.
Camden, desperation maneuver. But we're seeing an inability to capitalize. Watch out, here he goes. Oh!
Camden's feeling it now.
Oh! Those big time elbows. Jude's clothesline misses. No, Camden!
You can feel both men putting everything they have into these shots. Camden feeling victory right now.
Oh! Buster right in the center of the ring. Covers two, three, no. Oh, that was close. That was close.
You could see Camden felt it. He thought he had it right there. He nailed it perfectly in the middle of the ring.
That was close, guys.
Arn Anderson couldn't have done it better himself. I mean, maybe.
But here, look at this. This is the frustration of Camden I'm talking about. Too much time, guys. Too much time. Looking for that German.
Oh! That's one.
He's going to float through.
That's two.
Rolling
to the back of the head. If he hits that third one with that bridge, match is done.
He's tied. He's struggling to hold on. Jude Dizz countering. Jude Dizz clothesline misses. Third German.
Oh, with the bridge.
One, two, now. Again, Jude Dizz finds the wherewithal to kick out.
How many times have you seen Mike Camden put opponents away with that very maneuver?
Time and time again. You know, again, Jude Dizz, in that video package we saw, he says, I earned this. I earned this. You got to think that's deep within his mind right now. In his head, he's thinking it. I earned this. I can't give up. I can't quit.
And the crowd
walk out as champ.
And the crowd that's usually behind Camden is currently behind Ju Dizz.
Camden looking for that elbow again. No, one too many times. Ju Dizz capitalizing. Uh-oh. Maybe another mistake.
Oh! From the top, dragging him down. The mistake that may have been needed by Mike Camden to take total control and go for this victory.
Oh. Camden with another elbow, and guys, I'm telling you, this might be it. That might have been the last chance Ju Dizz had. We saw him come up empty from the top rope earlier. Up top again there. Ju Dizz is in a bad way here, guys.
Both men leaving everything they have out there, giving it their all tonight. Camden knows if he gets the victory here, he will walk out of here, and tomorrow when he wakes up, he will be the longest reigning champion we have had. The crowd split.
The crowd is split between both men, exchanging strikes on the top rope, but Camden's getting the better of it.
All the way up.
This is dangerous. This is dangerous.
He could have broke his back. Camden.
No. Everybody in the Oceanside, boys and girls, thought that was it. Everyone thought that was it.
When I saw the referee signal too, I could not believe that Judas kicked out.
Listen, guys, win or lose, Ju Dizz is showing the heart of a champion.
Oh, most definitely. Most definitely. And you can see us really starting to wear out Mike Camden. What is it going to take to put this guy away?
Is the doubt starting to get into Mike Camden's head? Oh, Ju Dizz with a roll up. No. Could have been it right there. Backside by Camden. No, Ju Dizz out of it. Camden out. Clothesline. Ju Dizz. Small package.
She has him.
One, two. No, Camden counters. No, Ju Dizz. One. Hooks him.
He got him.
New champ. New champ.
Wow.
Wow. Camden can't believe it. Camden can't believe it.
History has been made here tonight, guys. We have a brand new SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the match and new SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion, Ju Dizz.
Ju Dizz, his dream has come true all the hard work. And now he will go home tonight as the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion. And Mike Camden is beside himself, not sure. We understand how he's feeling right now. He would not let that title go. He grabbed it right away, coming to terms with what just occurred. Resnick, we know Mike Camden is an honorable guy. Looks like I'm getting ready for a presentation right here.
Yeah, looks like Camden's getting ready to essentially hand over the title to Ju Dizz and congratulate him.
Classy, that's classy.
On an incredible, incredible matchup. And it takes a big man to do what Mike Camden's about to do.
I mean, two of the most honorable men in there, two of the greatest athletes we have in SoCal Pro Wrestling today. Tremendous match by both. Both gave it their all.
It's a great show of sportsmanship here, guys.
Yeah. Everybody should clap for that. What a great round of applause. What a class act, Mike Camden. Oh!
What a cheap shot.
He just asking why, Mike, why? We talked about that gold fever getting to you, and it looks like it got to Mike Camden.
Mike Camden just cheap shotted Judas. I don't know what to think about what we saw, guys. Hey, the bottom line is this, guys. We saw an incredible matchup between Mike Camden and Judas, and there in the center of the ring is your new SoCal Pro Champion Judas.